In this video, I'm going to show you how we can create solar system app using MIT App Inventor. Solar system app. And okay. So let me show you a step by step, and we are going to learn here the maths formula also. So first of all, what do we need to do here? I'm going to use here the canvas. In the left side, you'll see the drawing animation. Just drag and drop the canvas here and make this width and height is fill parent like this. Okay, and I'm going to just change the background color of this. So I'm going to just change the background picture of that. So upload file, choose file, I have one that universe image. So I'm going to just open this and click on OK. So that's done, right? So we have uploaded one background image in the canvas. So I'm going to upload one planet also. So for that left side drawing animation, I'm going to use here the image sprite like this and upload file, choose file, and I'm going to upload the earth. Okay, so I have multiple planets. So this is the earth I'm going to upload. I'm going to change the resize that, pixels to 100 pixel. Let's try. But okay, but I need here one sun also. So I'm going to use here the one ball, or you can use another image spread. Okay, so I'm going to make that pixel to 70 something. So it's look fine. Yeah, good. I'm going to just copy paste this. Okay, and I'm going to just upload the another file here of sun. So upload file, choose file. Okay, now we need to move this earth around the sun. Okay, like this. So how we can do this? So first of all, we need to use your timer. So in the left side, you will see the sensor option. So close the user interface, sensors, and just clock. Okay, and interval is like 100 for now. Now we need to just go to the block section, and we need to create one simple procedure. Okay, so click on the procedure here, and we need to pass four values. Okay, so I'm going to use here the sine, cos, sine theta, and cos theta formula to move our earth. Okay, as you can see here, the sine cos table, this is sine theta 0, 30 value, 45, 60, and 90. As you can see here, these value like from 0 to 1, and then again 1 to 0. Okay, so same like as you can see here, once we get the value of sine theta or cos theta, one value, two value, so that will be around the circle, that will make a circle for you. If you don't know about this, so don't worry about all the formula I'll give you. Okay, here, so let's create the here, so like four values. Okay, so x, y values and one radius value. Okay, and one more value we need to use here for angle. Okay, so this is suppose cx, cy, this is the radius, and this is, you can say, angle value. Okay, and for the angle, I'm going to define the in slice global variable, and that is for now is 0. We need to increase it. Now we need to pass this value. Now we need to initialize these values. Okay, so how we can do this? Now we need to call the value. So we need to move the this image sprite. As you can see here, this is the earth. Okay, image sprite 1. So go to the block, call image sprite 1. Okay, and you can see the move formula, move to this one. Okay, now we need to get the x and y value. Okay, I'm going to use the timer, and we need to use the input here like this, and we need to click on the procedure, call this procedure here. Okay, and the radius value, I'm going to just put the the x value, I'm going to just put anything 234 for now, or you can check your earth location, like go to the design, as you can see here, the 48 and 26 for now. Okay, so let's give it a 48 and 26 for now. Okay, 48, but make sure we need to change that value according to how this earth is moving. Okay, so we'll change it later. So for the radius is something I'm going to just do 100 for now, and angle I'm going to just get that value from here. Okay, now we need to set the angle value, because we need to increase that angle value. So once I increase the angle value, as you can see here, this is, so this is something around 45 angle, right? So if I will increase the angle like 90 and then 180 and then again to 280 and 360 like this, so that will move like this. Okay, so I'm gonna just set the value. So I'm gonna use here simple the mod. I'll go to the maths, and we need to find the mod of, we need to use here the mod of, get this one. So mod of, we need to use first, we need to increase the angle value. Okay, so for that we need to use your maths. We need to increase that value, like angle we need to increase it every time. So every time we'll increase the y1 like this, every timer like this, and we need to divide it by 360. okay, because our whole angle is 360. Okay, if I will have the calculator, as you can see here, if I have the angle is 1 and the second number is 360, and if I will calculate the mod of this, so that will get 1. If I will just increase that value, this will increase, okay, 1, that will increase to 2. Okay, so how we can get that? As you can see here, this is the 1. Every time this will angle plus 1 equal 2, then 3, then 4, and that will be divided by 360. So suppose here the mod, like if I just suppose 20 and solve, as you can see, 20. So that if I will just have the 360, then again that will mod to 0. It means that will again, you know, that overall circle will move to the same position here. Okay, so this, that will move, that earth will move like this as a circle. So go here again, and we just need to do it. It's simple. Now we need to call it. So first of all, for the x and y value, we need to increase x and y value. Okay, so how we can do this? So simply, first of all, is I'm going to use the maths for the plus for the x, and I need to use the minus for the y, like this. Now get, we need to use here the x value, that should be plus, okay, and for the y value I need to minus than that, so our image speed will move. Okay, for the plus I need to use here the formula is radius into cos theta, cos value. Okay, so cos angle. So for that I need to use here the calculation, like maths, and call it calculation like this, and then we need to multiply by radius. This is the radius, and that radius should be multiplied by angle, but the angle value should be cos angle. Okay, so maths here, you can see the cos, this one cos, and cos value is angle. Okay, so angle value right now is 0 here, but that will increase, right? As you can see here, we have used a set angle value, okay, like this. So same formula we need to use here, but we need to change what, cos to sine, sine theta, like sine value, sine angle, like this. Simple as that. Okay, so I think there's no confusion for now. Let me just run this, how this will work, let's see, and then we'll use other planets also. So I'm going to use here the connect AI companion. I have the companion. As you can see, this is is moving, this earth is moving, but we need to change the clock value to 10, like this, and the radius, make sure this should be around 148. So we need to move our earth to the right position, like this, as you can see here. But it's not good because our sun is, where is our sun? So we need to move our sun like this, earth is like this. So I'm gonna just make the x value to y value, let's see, this is the x value, I'm gonna make it x to 216. Okay, so x value I'm gonna increase to 240. Okay, so oh, again that was close, I'm really sorry for that. Oh, it's working perfectly fine, right? So now we need to use here the multiple planets, right? So if I just image split 2 like this, if I can use here another, I have another planet, same, I need to use the block, I need to go to the block. The block is already copy paste. No, I need to call this same process for the image spread 3 also. Okay, and let's try this, if this will work. The, you know, x and y values are different, otherwise they will be collide maybe. Oh, as you can see here, yeah, maybe. So for that I can use here one thing, that I'm gonna use here the another procedure for that. Okay, so first let's check the this. Oh, this is the earth actually I'm using here, so I need to use here the instant of any other planet like this, but I can see here the both are okay. So for that it's simple, is that I'm gonna just change that value to something else. So how we can do this? So simply this procedure, I'll delete this, that will also pass the procedure 2, and I need to call the procedure 2 also, so I can use the another timer also for that. Or okay, so timer, I'm gonna just or I need to pass the value. Okay, so I must need to use, so I can call here procedure 2 also like this, and I can pass the same values. Okay, but for the radius it's fine, but for the XY I'm gonna use a 300 or 200. Oh, amazing. But as you can see, another planet. Oh no, but yeah, it's look good, very good. So I need to change one thing, that radius I need to reduce. Okay, so I'm gonna reduce to 200. Okay, like this. Oh, it's fine. That's the overall planet app. You can use here the multiple planets here. So this is really, and that app we have created using the MIT App Inventor. So it's really amazing thing. So if you have any doubt, you can ask in comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.